the first time watching your live stream so I can say thank you. Your DIY training videos saved our dogs from being rehomed. Learning the out command was the best thing to happen to us.
Justin, wow. Well, number one, thank you so much for coming on the live show. Thank you so much for the kudos. And, interesting how our content actually works, keeps dogs in homes, and keeps them from being killed. Who knew?
Who knew?
And I'm not making fun of you, Justin. I'm making fun of certain ideologists. Next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory and grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Yeah! We're live. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's a great Monday day. It was nice out today.
Is it Monday?
Yeah. Yes, it's Monday. It was great out today. Beautiful.
Yeah,
great weather.
It's hot.
Yeah,
it's sweating my ass off cleaning my car.
That's right. You went to the normal vacuum place that you go to. Free vax.
Yeah, but I got to clean too.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. So, good evening, everybody. How are you? This is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training and the wonderful Joelle. And this is the What Would Jeff Do show. It's a 1-hour show every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Don't forget, the Wednesday show has been exclusively moved to our Patreon channel. So if you want to go to our Patreon channel, you go to patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. And I like that.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Lower paced. I'm not as talking as fast, not as much snarkiness. So we actually probably none. And we definitely, get to the issues much better because we also don't record any of those clips. It's just kept right on the Patreon channel, stays up on the Patreon channel. We have a playlist for it. That's really great. And then don't forget, we've got a seminar this weekend in Austin, Texas, actually south of Austin. And one of them cities that end in Creek. So we'll be there. Can't wait to go see the wonderful state of Texas. Maybe we'll run into our buddy Dan over there. That'd be really, really, really nice. And that's a problem-solving seminar. So all of our seminars that we tour the country, we used to say the world, but now country. We don't even, not even North America.
Not even all 50 states.
That's right. We know Hawaii. We can now, but it's a challenge, but you can get there. We can get to Alaska by driving through Canada. But we can't make any unnecessary stops. Unnecessary stops. You can make stops, just not unnecessary stops. So it's like, officer, I did have to pee every 5 minutes.
Right.
Okay. So
I wanted to pee off this viewpoint.
That's right. Here. It's a great looking, it's like I went into that casino and had to use the bathrooms there. So that's, I heard the strip clubs got really nice bathrooms. And that is a problem solving seminar. This is a problem solving show. So you're going to hear me say the word punishment a lot. Now, punishment has been hijacked by people that call it abuse, but it's not. Actually, it's fact. It is the opposite of a reward. A reward is something you do to teach, increase, get more of a wanted behavior. A punisher is something you get to decrease, eliminate a behavior. That's just the way it is. You might not like it, but that's the way it is. You don't have to like it. But facts don't care about your feelings. And then we have the training center here, which is we specialize in intense dogs, human aggression, dog aggression, leash reactivity, a lot of separation anxiety, and then obviously all the basic commands. But we also deal with some easier dogs. But if you've got yourself a man eater or a dog killer or a dog fighting dog, not like a dog fighting dog, professionally dog fighting dog, but like a dog that goes after dogs, this is the place to go. This is the place to go. A lot of dogs also, we're not seeing being socialized enough. So we do a lot of public access training with all of these dogs. And the way this show works is you ask a question by typing in your little chat box down at the bottom. A lot of people on the YouTube channel like to do the top chat because their question goes to the top and get to throw us a little bit of money. But if you're listening to this on Facebook, thank you so much. If you're listening to this on Twitch, welcome to our community. Thank you so much. Feel free to share the show on all the different platforms. Listening to the replay, thank you. And if you're listening to any of the podcasts that we're on, thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. So, Joelle. Way we go.
Kathleen, woo, haven't caught a live in forever. Max is on the treadmill and I'm doing some recovery work because I skipped it this morning. Sorry, Joelle. Hope all is well.
So, Kathleen.
It's all good, Kathleen.
Yeah, it sounds like you're doing like three things. So, number one, don't apologize to Joelle.
Kathleen is crushing it.
Yeah.
She's a kick-ass client.
And actually, Joelle just made 11 new videos that will be going up on her YouTube channel. And she's making two new how-tos. It's not really recovery work, but it's stretch. So I guess it would be
mobility work.
Mobility work, like so you don't have to recover. Pre-recovery. Injury
prevention.
Yeah, injury prevention stuff. So that was really, really exciting. So we filmed that right before here. Joelle definitely has a jam-packed day. We like to get in every minute. And so congratulations on that. Next.
Ashley, happy Monday from rainy Florida. Hope you all are well. Things are good. Looking forward to watching the show. Hugs or elbow bumps, whatever.
That's fantastic. And Florida, just I don't get into politics, but man, you guys just passed an interesting rate hike down there. I will say that. Good luck to the small businesses, unfortunately. They didn't have enough to worry about. So next.
Melissa said hello and happy Monday, everyone.
Hey, Melissa, thanks for being here. Really
Megan, hey guys, from Megan Jacks in Finland.
Hey, Megan, how are you?
Peter S. Hi, J&J.
Hey, Peter S. Welcome back to the show.
Kathy B. Hey, everyone.
Kathy, it is wonderful to see you.
Tosh said hello, awesome humans.
Tosh, New Zealand, I love you. I miss you. Happy birthday, I think, right? I think you just had a birthday. And
it's a good memory, my God.
I hope you and your husband or boyfriend or whatever the significant other is in your life are doing well, and you're really enjoying your property and you're enjoying your business. And I can't wait to get out there and to see you. She's the one with the spinning bull terrier.
Yep. Melissa posted the link to your Patreon channel.
Thank you. Yeah, it's definitely a good thing to join. The thing on Patreon is all exclusive content. Every single piece of content that's on Patreon, you cannot see anywhere else. Next.
PCBRS said hey.
Hey, PCBRS. Hey, back to you.
Raquel from Brazil said, hey, guys, good to see you here on Twitch.
Ooh, hey, Raquel, nice to be here on Twitch. It's funny because if Angela says hey to me, I'm like, hey is for horses and oats are for goats.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a little... Why? You don't like the word hey?
No, it's just something we say.
Oh.
Yeah.
Megan said, Joelle, love your glasses. Oh, thank you. Those are my blue light glasses.
Yeah, Joelle's been doing a lot of... Anybody that works in front of a computer screen. Actually, I wonder if they're having that conversation with all the kids that are in front of their computers all day.
They probably should. They're very helpful.
They should be really talking to these kids about this. In fact, the school should be giving them out.
Yeah, they should.
Because you're not paying for the infrastructure of the schools anymore. So you might as well freaking pay for some $12 glasses.
And there's not enough information about it. Like, we don't know the effects of it yet.
No.
There's not really been a generation that's in front of screens as much as we are.
You know what would be a good video for you to do is maybe like kids that are sitting in chairs. You do, like you talked about it in some of your how-to stuff that we filmed tonight, was like, if you have an office job, that you should address something for the kids that are sitting in front of their chairs, in front of their screens, proper posture, do anything, help these kids out. Next. Even Angelo, like use Angelo as like the little how-to little character. Next.
Where are we? Jacob, how to teach my 3-month-old the out command. He keeps picking wood chips and rocks up, and I have to keep digging them out of his mouth.
So you can do the out command. Usually at 12 weeks old, we don't do a formal out command because it's pretty aversive. What I would do is I'd bonk the dog. Just say no and then bonk. If you don't know what a bonker is, it's a wrapped up towel. Depending on the weight of the dog, you might want to scale down the towel and scale the bonk. Next.
PCBRS, my husky is in between links for the prong. He has a lot of fur. Should I go up one or down?
Yeah, with a husky, I'd go up one. It'll stay. It should stay up. Next.
Jory, hey, J&J.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Jory. Keodefila, I'll catch on replay. Too busy at the moment.
Okay. Thanks for letting us know. Thanks for letting us know.
Too busy.
Yep.
Julie said hearts.
Thank you, Julie. Love you too, Julie.
New Eli's. Oh, yeah. I'm getting bumped constantly. Mm. Hi, I want to open a dog training business. I'm about to turn 18 and save money so it can be home-based. Any tips about how to start?
A million tips. That's what I do for a living also is I do consulting business. So number one, you can do a private one-on-one consult with me. So there's tons of things to do, but the number one thing to do is start working dogs. Work dogs for free. Intern under somebody right now to get as much experience as you possibly can. You can start out by walking dogs. All right. You learn a really good skill set from walking dogs, because walking is training. And then you can move on to training, or just get right into training. Start with friends and families. And I say this to anybody, whether you're 18 or 58, I say the exact same advice. So it's not because you're 18. In fact, one of the most successful dog trainers in New England, okay, started at the age of 17 years old. I believe he bought his first house at the age of 19. He actually had his parents work for him by the age of 20. And now he has two very large facilities, and he's probably just old enough to drink right now. Next.
Tosh said, cranking, doing well, thanks heaps, including the less almost non-existent spinning bull terrier.
Awesome.
Michaela, what is your top three things to not do when it comes to training reactive dogs?
I hate these double negatives. To not do? Well, don't redirect, number one. That doesn't work. That actually reinforces reactivity. Dog redirects, reward comes up, you have reinforced an unwanted behavior. Second one would be do nothing. Like a lot of people just don't do anything. And third one would be to walk away. Probably those are the three things that, number three, I don't know if that would be on the top three. It's probably going to be one. It's probably something else I would do besides that third thing. Not do besides that third thing. Mm. Probably not learn how to properly apply a punisher to stop it would be right up there. There you go. There's the third one right there. Next.
Justin, first time watching your live stream, so I can say thank you. Your DIY training videos saved our dogs from being rehomed. Learning the out command was the best thing to happen to us.
Justin, wow. Well, number one, thank you so much for coming on the live show. Thank you so much for the kudos. And, interesting how our content actually works, keeps dogs in homes, and keeps them from being killed. Who knew?
Who knew?
And I'm not making fun of you, Justin. I'm making fun of certain ideologists. Next.
Joe, good evening. My favorite dog training duo. I've used your advice with the bonker, which worked well with my two dogs' reactivity to other dogs on the walk. They still whine and look like they're loading as other dogs get closer, but they don't lunge anymore. Mm. Is there a way I could use the e-collar on them to warn, remind them to stay calm and stop whining instead of bonking?
Absolutely.
How high do I put the e-collars for such a correction? P.S. I've used the e-collar plenty for recall and basic obedience.
Using excellent. Yeah. So, Joe, as you know, anyone that knows anything about remote collars knows they can be used to train a behavior as well as to get rid of a behavior. It's one of the great tools out there that you can actually have multi-purpose. Also, you can do it up to a mile away. They have some that work up to 8 miles away, which are for a lot of the hunting dogs out there. But having a conversation at a whisper or a shout up to a mile away is pretty freaking incredible, if you ask me. So what you're going to do is you're going to use your marker word, which is no, and then you're going to stim. What level? Your dog will tell you the level. That's another thing about remote collars is dogs control the levels. Yes, we physically turn the button, but the dog communicates what level is most effective for it. Therefore, if a level 30, it doesn't stop a behavior, and a 50 does stop a behavior, the dog has told you 50 is the behavior stopper. Next.
The behavior stopper. Kara, wanting to make some hoodies and t-shirts to advertise my business. Should I use my Facebook page link to have people find me or my email on the clothing?
Neither. Sorry.
Only other thing is my personal phone number. I really don't want my number on it.
No, don't put your phone number on anything. You don't even have to put your phone number on a business card. You put it on your website, but you advertise your website. Advertise your website. If you don't have a website, they're $14 and under. Jump onto Squarespace, register your website, build a simple one-page website if you have to. You'll be able to do it by the end of the night tonight. There's so many templates on Squarespace that you can easily drag and drop anything, and your phone number will be on there. But advertise your website. Your Facebook page will be too long. Definitely don't want to put your personal number on there because you're going to get all the wrong clients. And the other option was what? Email. No, you don't want to put your email address on there. Next.
Ava, my 7-month-old pup is no longer reactive and is able to play with other dogs after prong training and lots of structure.
Nice.
Do you recommend walking is only for walking and shouldn't say hi to other dogs on leash?
100%. The walk is the walk is the walk. We just had a dog on a one-on-one dog come in here today. One-on-one means the one-on-one client. I teach all of those dogs right now. I've been running the company. I still run the company, but I've got a fantastic, fantastic staff, but they're so busy right now that we had to make a decision about, we actually stopped doing one-on-ones, but we brought them back, but I'm teaching all the one-on-ones, and we had a dog that is very, very reactive. It's a 1-year-old German Shepherd, but guess what? It goes to doggy daycare all the time. It's very friendly with dogs, but it's so excited to see them that it comes out in reactivity. So the walk is the walk is the walk. Going outside to go to the bathroom is a walk. Whenever there's a leash on the dog and you're actually walking it, it is a structured walk. If you want it to be unstructured, it would be like more of like a leash drag. Next.
CT Vader, just saying hi. We had a few bonking instances, maybe 5 total. And the change in our 15-month-old lab has been night and day. No more towel stealing, pillow stealing, etc. Thank you for all you teach.
So what you're trying to say is that you kept your dog out of the emergency room having to be cut open from eating and swallowing pillows, towels, you know, anything in the laundry basket, all because you threw a wrapped-up towel at your dog that cost $1.32 at Walmart. That is just incredible.
The dog that eats towels now respects the towel. Interesting.
This bonker thing is incredible. It's one of the reasons why in all of our seminars, we demonstrate it. Everybody learns how to do it. We do it here at the training center. We don't use it to train an obedience command. We use it to apply a punisher in a very calm way. We mark it with no. We do it right before or at the moment the dog is exhibiting the unwanted behavior, and it works. And it's worked in my hands thousands of times, in my social media audience's hands tens of thousands of times, and believe it or not, in my fellow colleague dog trainers who will not admit it, a lot of dog trainers are using bonkers out there. Why? Because it works, and that's the job. Next.
Kristen, Madison, Wisconsin here. 122-pound lab that paws at me, not nice sometimes. I get up and walk away, but how to stop it?
First of all, stop having your dog train you. So your dog has literally trained you to move out of a room. You need to flip that. You need to flip it. You don't ever move out of the way of a dog. You never let a dog tell you what to do. That's like having a 4-year-old determine the color of your minivan, which I have seen before. Mommy, I don't like the red minivan. Oh, okay, honey. We'll get the color that you like. And that is the pukiest lime green ever that you will be driving around in. So what you do is you teach your dog the out command. Out command also means move away from something. I have free videos on my YouTube channel. You'll be able to do that by my next show, and it is fantastic. You can out your dog away from any object, yourself, a water bowl, a refrigerator, a toy, the couch, a guest, another dog, a food, you know, a bone, anything. Next.
Julio, hello. My 11-month pit does fine with dogs at a dog park off leash. when I go on walks and she's on leash, she barks at them. What could be wrong?
So number one, Julio, I highly recommend you don't go to a dog park. Dog parks are toxic. Also, your 11-month-old dog will be going into adulthood soon and could change. Dog parks tend to be breeding grounds for bad behavior and disease. But again, that's based on your choice. As far as the reason why the dog is barking, it's barking out of excitement and arousal. It actually wants to go over and say hi at them. That is why your dog is barking. So there's both things I would stop. I would stop. Next.
PCBRS, do you have any recommendations for a dog trainer in Orange County?
So I only give out the name of one dog trainer who's a colleague of mine, and that would be, you can give Sean O'Shea at The Good Dog a call, thegooddog.net. And publicly, that's the only dog trainer I will give out. Privately, I maybe give out half a dozen other ones, because unfortunately in my industry, there's a lot of dog trainers out there that are extremely good, but unfortunately, they're not very nice. And I would never send someone to another human being that can't be respectful of another human being. Next.
Melissa posted the link to Jeff Gellman Seminars.
Thank you so much. And they're going on. They're going strong. We have 4 left this year. We're really excited about that. This weekend, we have Austin, Texas. Then we're out in Ramona, California. Then Phoenix, Arizona. And then back to Providence. We'd always do an end of the year Providence one, which is the only one of the year that I do at reduced pricing with special free gifts. And that's because we do it Christmas weekend. And it's my big thank you to everybody for a wonderful year. Next.
Angela, really excited for next Saturday. See y'all then. Yay.
Can't wait to see ya.
Brohammed said Bonk City.
Bonk City. That's actually a new Nintendo Switch game. It'll be coming out very, very soon. Angelo is working on the coding right now as we speak.
Edward, any future thoughts of opening training facilities all over the world?
Never.
Or franchising?
Never.
Love the workout video. Help Joelle. They help. Thanks.
Edward, I am not interested in franchising. I'm not interested in multiple facilities. I'm interested in doing seminars around the world, and I'm interested in doing one-on-one online consulting, but I'm not, my business model, I am not interested at all at expanding at all. Dog training is very personable. I've seen the model out there. I don't think the model is anything great whatsoever. And there's no reason, frankly, for it to be franchised. I'm a huge independent owner, hard worker, business kind of person. And I have no problem going around teaching people how to open up businesses, but I'm not interested in actually, you know, franchising my own. But thank you.
Raymond, my dog growls at my adult daughter when she pets our dog's head. You said in the past that dog should be bonked. My daughter doesn't want to do the bonking. If I'm with her, can I do the bonking? And should she or I be the one to say no?
You can say no and you can bonk, but first of all, how old's your daughter? I mean, if your daughter is, 5, I get it. If your daughter is maybe even 12 or 13, I get it. But it sort of goes with the territory. If you're going to, you know, I believe that every dog owner and any adult, let's say your daughter's 18, should be able to actually apply a correction punisher to the dog. You can't just have the good stuff. It's also a lesson in life. It's also a very important lesson in life that unfortunately life doesn't always give you the good stuff. You also have to do some of the difficult stuff in life to get the good stuff. Next.
That is true. Ashley said little dog came in wearing a, what is that? Pheromone collar.
Yeah. It's usually used for calmness and anti-anxiety.
Oh, I have since removed it today. She just seems spacey. She's engaged when working, but once that stops, she's in la-la land. Even watching her in the kennel help.
So, the idea behind the pheromone collar, number one, just Google it, you know.
I've never even heard of
that. It's used to calm the dog down. I personally would rather use training to do that. So I'm not going to say I'm against a pheromone collar. If nothing else worked, you tried everything else you could to get rid of, say, separation anxiety, and we're really good at it. When I say everything, I means that means everything. A lot of people say, we've tried everything. I'm like, have you tried a remote collar? Oh, no. Well, then you haven't tried everything. Have you tried bonking? Oh, my God, no. Well, then you haven't tried everything. Like, if you have not tried a punitive-based approach to stop an unwanted behavior, you're actually, it's a disservice to your dog. You've left out 50% of the story. Mm-hmm. You've left out 100% of the story that actually works.
Yeah.
Just think about it that way. You literally have left out 100% of the story that works, because you can't stop it through a reward-based system. So, next.
New Eli's. There are a lot of dog trainers in my area. Should I be concerned about opening my business in my area?
No, there's not enough of them. There's only one New Eli's dog training business. There's only one. That's it.
True.
So I wouldn't be concerned at all. So do the math. I mean, if you do the math. I remember, I'll tell you a story. I'm in Lexington, Texas, and a wonderful one of my attendees was a dog trainer from Dallas, Texas. I'll take one of those. Yeah. And she was worried about the competition of dog trainers. And I said to her, In Dallas, Texas, how many dogs, pet dogs, do you think there is? And she had no idea. I'm thinking to myself, Dallas, Texas, conservatively, probably about 100,000. How many dog trainers
probably
do you think?
That.
Well, that's why conservatively.
Yeah.
How many dog trainers are in Dallas? Probably not more than 50. But let's say there was 100. That's still 1,000 dogs per dog trainer.
Mm-hmm.
That's assuming that they all went to a dog trainer.
Right.
But I said to her, what do you do? She goes, I do board and train. How many dogs can you handle? She goes, I only do 3 a month. So you only need to find 36 dogs in the city of Dallas. That's just if you get them from Dallas. There's a lot of other cities around Dallas. But you only need 36 dogs a year and you'll be fine. Don't tell me you can't find 36 dogs. So I think we have to, when you break things down and you look at the data and you look at the facts, things become a lot more reasonable. It's like when I say to somebody, you do realize that you can make $100,000 a year dog training. What? Oh, no, 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 no. That's $2,000 a week, $300 a day. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Next.
Angela agreed on the out command, must have.
It's important. Yeah, the out command is like one of our best commands.
Mimi, my dog knows recall. While practicing with distractions, he's hesitant to come. Leash pops, guidance get him to me, but he sits facing the distraction, not me. Tuned out the entire time, doesn't take food.
So if you don't have a dog that is, if you have a dog that is not food motivated, you've got to use more compulsion. What is compulsion? Leash pressure. Leash pressure. So you unfortunately have not become relevant enough on the recall command. Recall is the come command or the hear command. It's calling your dog back to you. So what do you have to do? Become relevant. How do you become relevant? If you had food, that really doesn't make you relevant. But
he said he's not even taking food.
Right, but you could use food. We use food to train dogs, and then we wean the dog off food. Then you have to use leash pressure. A couple of good, strong pops when the dog is being a little bit slow on the recall, a little bit too distracted, and then when the dog sits facing the other way, back up 5 feet, say come again, nice firm leash pop, you'll become relevant. Next.
Jacob is 3 months old, too young for a prong collar and or e-collar. Is there a language for the e-collar that I should be initially teaching my dog before using for punishment and recall?
Absolutely, 100%.
It is meaning you should not be using it to apply a punisher. And 3 months is too young. What I want you to do, you have a 12-week-old dog. Don't even think about the remote collar or the prong collar. You should be doing massive amounts of marker and food training. Use the dog's daily kibble, not treats. The dog's daily kibble. Don't let the dog eat out of a bowl. Use its daily kibble. Put it in a little bag, a little treat pouch. That's how the dog trains. You should be doing 20 to 30 reps of every single command a couple of times a day. And then you're going to be teaching your dog what the words mean. Next.
$4.99 top chat from Ashley. Damn good rant tonight. Blunt and to the point. Keep them coming. Those always pump me up. Oh, Ashley.
I've done a rant?
I guess so.
Oh, well, thank you, Ashley. You actually don't want to hear my real rants. Next.
You've been full of them lately. Brohamed, 8-month leash reactive border collie. Prong collar for about a month now, and he has made huge progress. Cars, dogs, he loves fetch. I heard it reinforces reactivity, more harm than good.
So, Brohamed, whomever or whatever group you heard that a prong collar reinforces...
No, fetch. Playing fetch reinforces reactivity.
You sure? Okay.
I mean, he said it in the same sentence. He loves fetch. Okay. Heard it reinforces reactivity.
Okay. So
he's just saying his dog's been making so much progress.
Okay. So I will then thank you for clarifying that. I will start
before
out
before you went off on a tirade.
But I will start out the same.
Okay.
Whomever or whatever group told you that fetch reinforces reactivity has no fucking clue what they are talking about. Okay?
Here we go.
Hashtag truth.
Heating up.
Hashtag fact. Hashtag no fucking clue. Next.
New Eli's, any books or websites you recommend for me to learn about the legal part of how to open a home-based dog training business?
I would go to, I've got a good website for you to go to, Eli. Write this down.
Here we go.
It's long, so write it down.
Here we go. Commonly
misspelled. Ready? www.google.com.
I heard that one coming from a mile away.
I love you, Eli. I really do. Next.
Oh, Shayna, training a 5-month-old female sheepdog standard poodle mix who was great, except when I put the prong collar on her last week. She was a terrible puller, so prong collar is the only way to go. She went ballistic.
So, a couple of things. Prong collar is not just for pulling dogs. Prong collar is a communication device used to communicate a training philosophy theory. Without that, it doesn't work. I have seen dogs go ballistic with harnesses on, slip leads on. In fact, the loudest dog, the most dramatic dog, the loudest screamer, the most longest time it screamed, as well as weeks of screaming, was from a slip lead, a simple nylon slip lead. So the prong collar is just something the dog was objecting to, not because it hurts. Because it was objecting to it. So cleaning your room does not hurt. Kids have hissy fits. Putting your cell phone down and not bringing it to the dinner table does not hurt, but teenagers have hissy fits. That's all that was literally a hissy fit objection. Work the dog through it. Next.
Ava, thanks so much. So my pup is not as sensitive to the prong now. When we pass something exciting, he's pushy by sitting down and whining. Can't seem to correct enough. I don't have e-collar, just prong.
All right. In order for the dog to sit down, that means the human had to come to a stop. Unless you're dragging that dog's ass and exploding its anal glands and wrecking its sphincter, I've got a feeling you're stopping when the dog is sitting. Therefore, the dog has trained you. Move. Just keep moving. Keep moving. Got it. Next.
Megan, someone I follow who has a large following shared your Why We Bonk video and hated on it. It's so disappointing because she's never heard of you guys and has no idea of all the good you guys do.
Because Megan, first of all, don't
pretty typical.
So don't tell me who it is. Okay. And this is the thing. Think about that.
Yeah.
Just think about this concept.
I have no idea who we even are.
Not even that part, but I wake up every morning and I try to figure out how I can help the most amount of people, and mostly for free. 99.99% of the people I will ever come in contact through social media, I will never meet or get a dime from. And it's into the hundreds of thousands. This person who goes unnamed and will be remain unnamed because I think it's unprofessional to name somebody. They wake up in the morning and they want to know who can they try to make look bad because they have self-esteem and self-worth issues and it makes them feel better. And they don't care about you. They don't care about dogs. They don't care about the dog owner. Because if they did, they would realize how powerful bonking is. And this is the theory. So I'm a horrible person. Unless I trained exactly like she does, then I would not be a horrible person. Correct? So, what does Ben say? Unification does not mean exactly the same. It means being understanding and open to what everybody else does and still being unified, even though you don't still believe in it. Something like that. It's a shorter phrase, but it's like it's accepting a lot of things, even though you personally don't do it. So I like you as a person. We might disagree on religion, for instance. That's a common one. Mm-hmm. But it's like, but you're a good human being at the core. Mm-hmm. You can have that. So this person, they have their philosophy is, I would be a nice person if I didn't bonk anymore and if I trained like she did. Mm-hmm. So all of a sudden, now I'm a nice person. That also is a issue that I wonder about, like what their moral compass is. Next.
Justin, when going on a pack walk, do you allow the dogs to switch their positions in relation to you? Sometimes my dogs end up switching, being on the inside when we practice changing directions.
You could do that unless you had a dog that was if you had a dog that you had to keep your eyes on a little bit more. I like them on the inside right next to me at all times. If I have to have a conversation with them, they're close by. Next.
Jeff said, matching glasses.
Well, those are blue glasses. Mine are not still as shiny.
I have somewhat of eyesight. I probably do need glasses, but I'm just still kind of wearing them.
Do you think so?
Oh, yeah. My right eye is really bad compared to my left.
Is it? So you probably should look into that. Next.
DJJ, hey, Jeff. If my dog stops whatever he's doing when I said no, do I still need to correct by bonking? Thanks.
Well, you don't have to necessarily bonk. At the beginning of your rehab / training journey, you absolutely should follow through, even though, the no has stopped the behavior. But if every morning when we go, when we go out and take a hike, if the dogs are like a little bit hyped up, we'll say, cut the shit, knock it off. No, they stop. Nobody's delivered a consequence, But at the beginning of the training, I think it's important you stay consistent.
Yeah. J-Ron. Hey, J&J. How are you guys doing? My girlfriend is very happy and emotional because she was mopping, cleaning, and super stayed all the time in place, snoring, and couldn't care less.
So, I love super. J-Ron.
Such a good boy.
You have discovered one of the secrets in life. One of the secrets of a happy marriage.
Is true.
If she's happy, we're all happy.
It's true.
Congrats.
New said Jack Russell mix that is dog reactive and pulls on the leash. Suggestions.
Sure. So what you're going to do is Jack Russell, you know, fit it with a proper 2.25 millimeter prong collar. Again, why do we talk about prong collar so much? Because they give the average dog owner, or even an experienced dog owner, leverage to have a conversation with the dog. Teach the dog how to properly heel next to you, for starters. Now, heeling and dog reactivity have nothing to do with each other. So you can have a dog that has a perfect heel and is still dog reactive, a dog that has a horrific heel that is not dog reactive. But you got to start out somewhere. So let's start out with proper heel. Then what you're going to do is, as soon as you start seeing the dog load, load is the dog is thinking about being dog reactive. So the alcoholic is walking up to the bar, or walking to the actual the bar on the outside, about to open up the door. That's when the conversation starts. And that should involve you grabbing their arm and pushing them away, because they're in rehab and you're trying to keep them sober. So it's the same with dog reactivity. We apply the biggest punisher as soon as the dog thinks about it. As far as pulling, I've got tons of videos on all that stuff. That's it. That's the teacher's dog got a heel and it won't pull anymore. Next.
Shayna shut down completely, yelped, "Oh, this is the dog with the prong collar." Spun around, wouldn't move, couldn't motivate her in any way. Owner was very upset. Now not allowed to use the prong. What to do?
I would drop the client. Mm-hmm. I would drop the client. So we always tell our clients, number one, that that could happen. And our clients go, yeah, we've seen the video. So we have a video on that. So the thing is, it's like yelped, spun around, and wouldn't move. I have seen a dog do that with every other collar.
Yep.
Putting a prong collar on a dog does not hurt a dog. Giving a dog a leash pop does not hurt a dog. And for all the people out there, this is one of the stupidest comments you will ever hear. The stupidest comments you will ever hear. Then why does it work if it doesn't hurt the dog? Are you fucking kidding me? Do you realize that I could use food, and we do use food, to teach a downstay? So now are you going to tell me that I taught a dog a downstay with food, so the reason why the dog is doing the downstay, because food must have hurt it? That fucking makes no sense. Why does it work? It must have hurt. That's the most ridiculous thing in the world. Next.
Oh, boy. Ernie, no issues tonight. Just wanted to say nice video on Enzo this morning and awesome work as usual.
Oh, thank you, Ernie. God, that was a fucking early morning video, too.
Sure was.
Was that Sunday?
Mm-hmm.
God damn. Next.
Sharon, dog was fully house trained until we moved to northern Canada, negative 30 outside. Now back south and still refusing to potty outside. Can I e-collar or bonk when he pees in the house?
Now, there's a couple of division theories on that. If you catch the dog in the act, can you correct the dog? I say yes. I say if you catch the dog in the act, I say yes. But some people will say don't do it, because then the dog will just find a place that you can't see to piss. My response to that is, why can't you see your dog? Like, where's your dog that you can't see it? Next.
Kara, what do you do about a dog that slides his front feet forward when sitting?
Nothing. I don't care. I'm not a competition dog trainer. I mean, if you want to, you can make yourself a sitting box. It's a box they use in competition to get a dog to square off properly, but that's not what I do. I'm a family pet dog trainer. If you sit and your feet slide forward a little bit, I mean, if you're on like a linoleum floor and they slide the dog into a down, which does happen.
I've seen it.
Okay, it happens a lot, actually. I've seen it with like Great Danes. You know, it's like just gravity and slippery floor. It's like, whoop.
Yeah.
Yep. Next.
Melissa posted the link to my Patreon channel. Thank you, Melissa.
You know, and one thing about Joelle's Patreon channel, it's fantastic. And it really... it's for 10 bucks a month, you can change your life. Because when you start changing things physically with yourself, you start changing things mentally with yourself. Try to change things mentally with yourself, you start becoming a better human being. Start becoming a better human being, and the world is changing. So that's the power of your channel. You're changing the world, baby. Nice job.
Kara, been working with one of our dogs for a couple of months with separation anxiety from other dogs. Dog rarely whines ever anymore when separated, but still drools a lot, even with head down in the crate. Should I expect that to ever go away?
I hope so. Drooling is the one thing that I don't control. That's like trying to stop farting. Like, how does one do that? I mean, me, I can just clench my sphincter muscles together and I can stop it.
I cannot.
But how are you going to... How?
Like, who says that? I can clench my sphincter muscles together.
If you're in a crowded room...
Jeff just like working with a client, like walking around like he has a stick up his ass.
If you're in a crowded room...
Yeah, you better clench that shit.
Thank you. Who says that? You just said it.
Who talks about it, though? Like, you don't talk about bathroom habits.
That's so weird. You think the only place that people fart is in the bathroom?
Yes.
There's no farting involved at all. That's the full Monty.
Okay.
That's number two. Boom. Splish, splash. Taking a bath.
Stop it.
Next. So the drooling, like, I don't know if it'll go away, but chances are if the dog is calm, it'll go away. Next.
Tosh said, new t-shirt. You can't always have the good stuff.
No, you can't.
Heather, bonking totally works. Just started with my puppy and it was weird at first, but it works.
You know, I think that as far as the punishers are concerned, it's one of the most powerful. It is invasive, but it's the most practical thing to do. Mm-hmm. I mean, put it this way. Grandma has been throwing shit at the dogs for centuries. Mm-hmm. Centuries. If your grandmother is alive right now.
We should rename it. Instead of the bonker, it's the granny toss.
The granny toss.
The granny towel.
Right. If your grandmother is alive right now and she's over 70, ask her, and she had dogs growing up. Ask her when the dogs were in the house barking at the front door. Ask your grandmother, what did they do? 9 out of 10 times, they would say, I looked around for shit to throw, and I threw it at the dog. Sometimes I would take off my shoe.
La chancla.
She's been thrown at dogs for centuries. Well, does that make it right? Yeah, because it works. Next.
J-Ron, Joelle rocking the nerdy look. Sorry, Jeff, not hating.
Well, J-Ron, thanks, J-Ron. You know, I don't look at it as, number one, having glasses being nerdy for coming from someone that was called four eyes all his life. So don't bring back those fucking memories of my miserable elementary school.
I thought you wore contacts, like, up until recently.
Not when I was 8 years old.
Oh.
They didn't even have contacts, I don't think.
Oh, you needed glasses, like, your whole life?
I've had glasses all my whole life, yeah.
Oh.
I had glasses when there was two styles, ugly and uglier. That's it.
So you know, like the Coke bottle ones, like circular.
I remember going shopping for eyeglasses and I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? You guys can't come up with anything more fashionable than this. I mean, green shag rug was more fashionable than my eyeglasses.
Wow.
They were terrible.
They were horrific.
They were horrific. Next.
Emma just rescued a 3-month-old puppy that turned out to have nutrition deficiency that causes his legs to bow badly.
Yeah.
He now has splints, bandages on his front legs. Correct the issue. Also directed to limit his food intake to 2/3 cup a day.
Huh?
How can I build confidence with this puppy with limited food source to train with?
Well, how big is the dog? 2/3 of a cup? And it's 3 months old and growing? Must be a small ass dog. 12-week-old dog on not even one cup of food. That dog's got to be under 10 pounds.
Yeah.
Small.
And it has
dog.
A nutrition deficiency, so why would they be cutting its food?
Well, they might be taking vitamins, supplements.
Yeah.
I hope so. Well, you can just use, you're using one piece of kibble at a time. Next.
Lori, the good dog training business in our area is 3 months wait for board and train. Not enough good trainers.
No, there's not enough good dog. Yeah, we've got a 2-month weight right now, but we've got, you know, four trainers on, and we can, and we also turn away a lot of clients. Like, I can easily get more clients, but I want my clients to win and be successful. And we also work with harder dogs.
Yeah.
Next.
Jules, dog is not always stopping behavior with bonking, but rather becomes nippy or air biting. Smaller dog, Shih Tzu mix. Tips.
Jules, you're probably not bonking firm enough. No, bonk. Bonk hard. Next.
Emma said his food is limited until his bones can strengthen up to his body weight.
Oh, I see.
Jamie, can you train prey drive out of a dog?
I don't know about that, but I wouldn't want to. I just want to control it. I want to turn it on and off. I don't want the dog's prey drive to go away. So, for instance, Tex chases coyotes and rabbits and deer. Pretty much anything that's out in the environment, he'll chase. He'll want to chase. So I don't want him doing that, but I want him to chase the ball, and I want him to hunt for the ball. So I want him to have good hunt drive and good prey drive, good ball drive. So I wouldn't want to train that out of him, but I want to have yes and no protocols for those things. Next.
Jules, dog park, more harm than good?
Yes, it is more harm than good. Next.
Joe, thanks for your work. Been a lifesaver. Bonker, prong collar, e-collar made my dog able to off-leash after being an aggressive dog killer.
Good job, Joe. Joe, just remember in your back pocket, your dog's old behavior. Take proper safety protocols and always have that remote collar on that dog and always be training. Good job. Next.
Charles, my two-year-old lab restarted being destructive now that he stays alone again. I feel very bad crating him again. Any suggestions?
Charles, you're going to have to get over the crating thing. So, who is that? Charles? Who said that?
Charles.
Charles, you come home from work and your dog is on the ground. And there's a pillow half eaten next to it. And the dog's stomach is totally distended. And it's having a hard time breathing. And you reach into its throat and you realize that you pushed the stuffing farther down the throat. And you get in your car and you take the dog with you and you rush to the emergency room. And the whole time you're driving the 15 minutes to the emergency room through the pouring rain, you're thinking, is my dog going to die? And how much is this going to cost me? Now, you've got to take that thought and then reframe that with how bad you really feel about crating your dog. Next.
PCBR, why is prong and e-collar training not used on a three-month-old? How many months old should you start using them?
Well, because a 3 months old is a critical time. First of all, it's not necessary because I want to be spending that time on all of my baseline stuff. But number one, it's like I don't expect a two-month-old to run a 100-yard dash. Right? Let alone crawl one. I mean, they're not even doing tummy time yet. So I want to spend all that time doing it to start getting it focused on its marker work, to understand its yes markers, and to start motivating it with food training and to build up its confidence. Next.
Joe, you saved my dog's life and free of charge. Thank you, Jeff.
Joe, number one, thank you for the kind words. I do appreciate it. I just want you to know that. But I want you to also look in the mirror and thank yourself, because I'm just the guy with a big mouth, and you're the one doing all the hard work. And I truly, truly mean that. So, you know, see, this is why it doesn't bother me that people spew hate at me.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't bother me. Because I know, like, people are like, how could he sleep at night? I'm like, I fucking sleep really well. Well, actually, I have a hard time sleeping. But it's not because of how I train dogs. But I sleep just fine knowing that I'm busting my ass every day saving dogs' lives. You know, how do you sleep knowing that you're such a hateful, angry person?
That's the question.
That's the real question, you know? So, but you're doing all the hard work. And that I appreciate you on. Next.
Good job, Joe.
Yes.
Christine, that's the world today. Everyone thinks, think like me or else.
Pretty much.
Ain't that the damn truth?
Pretty much. We will never dabble in politics here, even though I've thrown in a couple of side remarks. And that's not when I say the word snowflake, by the way.
It doesn't have anything to do with politics. Dog training, too. Everything. Think like me or else.
Right. So I'm just referring to that one comment that someone's like, I said the word snowflake. It's like snowflake has been around way before it was used
in
politics. Okay, snowflake started coming in 2020. That's the word snowflake was started.
Don't sneeze.
In 2020. I'm not going
to
sneeze.
I feel like you were about to sneeze. You're like doing like the look around, like, and then you went like this.
Is that my pre-sneeze?
That's like everyone's pre-sneeze.
That's my pre-sneeze protocol?
Yes.
Oh, is it really? Huh.
Yeah, I stopped the thought.
Oh, is it really?
Bonk you in the head.
Uh-huh. Yep.
Shayna, I kept walking, but dog was concrete, so I couldn't walk her through it.
Probably the one that sat.
Oh.
So unless that dog was 200 pounds, you can walk the dog through it. So.
Heather, any good recommendations on how to socialize a puppy in this new social distancing world? I have an 8-month-old shepherd mix rescue. She's afraid of everything. Uh-oh.
So number one, Heather, I would find some close friends. Ooh. You know, that you can socialize with. Also, social distancing doesn't have to be like necessarily meeting your dog. You can expose your dog to as many environmentals as possible without actually your dog interacting with them. Next.
Maria, I want to tell you that we've received a snowfall of 40 centimeters. And thanks to you, I can have my dog play in the snow with no leash, with a very good recall. I couldn't do this time ago because my dog wouldn't listen or would chase bunnies. So I'm always thankful for your knowledge and sharing. Wow. Love from Saskatchewan.
Wow.
Amy, Wes is getting all worked up.
I know.
My COVID treat to myself was the purchase of an e-collar, 8-year-old Doberman with high prey drive.
Nice.
History of chasing cattle and deer, yeah. Put the work in watching these lives. Yesterday went to a new location and walked past lots of dogs, right. Bikes, people, runners, and she's on autopilot. Returned to me immediately, down at my side, waited until released. We previously practiced when people were about 100 yards to return to me and down. Now it's automatic.
Wow. Very, very nice. Hey, everybody, thank you so much for joining us. We had a really, really fun time tonight. We'll see everybody, if you're part of our Patreon family, on Wednesday nights. If not, we'll see you on Friday night. And we'll be actually broadcasting from Austin, Texas, which is going to be really, really exciting. Take care.